Magic Carpet is a system that helps automate the landing process on the carrier so that the pilot only has to make little adjustments during the approach while they're landing. And so it just sort of makes it easier for them during the landing, which is one of the most difficult parts of their job.
Around about April of last year, it became clear that the fleet really wanted Magic Carpet sooner than later. But that's when kind of hit that the fleet trainers were not going to be updated in time to support the scheduled software release.
We had a gap between, hey, we're delivering in capability with the airplane, but we don't have a training tool. So again, we fell back to our personnel resources within NAVAIR at our sim facility, and we built a very low cost desktop trainer.
Magic Carpet Ride is a portable desktop trainer, and it was used as the initial training and kind of the first look for pilots as to how to fly the Magic Carpet modes and to get familiar with the HUD symbology and what they'll be seeing in the aircraft when they go to fly it for the first time.
You know, we had this tool, this simulation, already in-house that we used for development of the program. And we thought, well, why not just use that, but put it in a smaller package so we wouldn't have to deploy a whole cockpit and visual system and you know, training environment.
Since it was going to be mobile, we had to ensure that we could carry it on board an airline, that it was packaged into the checked-in baggage. The baggage then would form the pedestal support for which we would build on that system.
From then on, it was just about coming up with structure to support the monitors and to hold the joystick and the throttle, and design all that, and then get on a schedule to deploy it to the squadrons that were ready for it.
We had an interim short-term need, so I found a summer hire on the Pathways program. The unfortunate part was he had 5 days left before he went back to college. So we sat down in my office and laid out what the expectations for something we've not created needed to look like.
Essentially wanted a rig that could support the Magic Carpet system and also pack down into itself so that it could be shipped wherever it needed to go.
It's really two screens, so a heads up and a heads down display. The heads down display is touchscreen so that pilots can interact with it and make changes. And then there's a joystick and a throttle. Then we just had, it's really a desktop tower computer is what we used. And there's a graphics card in there. Some speakers so that the pilots can get noise when they're flying, get that engine sound. And that's really all that goes into it.
The main consideration was to get everything placed like it would be in the cockpit and for it to fit inside the case so that it could be shipped easily and not need a bunch of boxes.
The benefit of MC Ride was that we could then take the air crew in and do hands-on flying to the boat, letting them see both the normal operations, how to interact with the head-up displays, how to interact with the heads-down displays, also how to interact when the system was degraded, how to recognize degradations in the system, and then what you do in the airplane.
These simulators that we developed were the stopgap solution. So those, once the fleet trainers are updated with the proper software, then the simulators are done and we'll go back and collect them.
Being able to reach in-house really solved the time problem. It solved the cost issue because we had people right there, but it's just the how to do it with the time remaining was the difficult part. So not only reaching out to the Pathway students, but we reached out to ESDPs and basically just said, here's the requirements.
I was very lucky to get to go out to two trips and get to witness the training and set up the system there and witness the pilots training on it. And it was very motivating for me as a young engineer to hear their feedback of how much of an impact this is making, the software in general, as it's a project that I'm working on, and to see them be able to use the trainer and kind of have fun and enjoy it. And it is motivating, is definitely the best way that I can describe it.